Hello guys, it is your boy Steve here once again with a new video. Haha, no, just kidding, it is still your boy SubZeroXTabyte, but we are in the Minecraft beta and they didn't have skins yet, so I am a bit undercover as Steve. Don't worry though, it is still me, but I just look different. I look noob, so that is not really that fantastic, but I guess it is fantastic that we are back in the old Minecraft and it just kind of looks amazing. The simplicity of it is just great. But anyways, we are going to take some wood and we have a couple logs of wood, but we need a whole lot more if we are going to build some nice house or something. It is kind of sad that there is not a lot of things that we are going to be able to add to that house though, since not everything that is in Minecraft at the moment is in the beta, so we are just going to live off simplicity. And this beta is already just amazing to me. Look at the textures and stuff. Like, the not a lot has changed, but they are still just as beautiful as before, and like the grass is just normal grass, only now it is old grass, but it is still new grass, only it is in the old Minecraft, so it is kind of old grass. But we are out here on the sand on our crafting table and we are the king of the Sahara, and I am just going to craft some of the basics. Well, only the basic, since if you just make a wooden pickaxe then you don't make a wooden axe, because you can go down somewhere, pickaxe some stone, and then you can make a stone pickaxe. So it would just be a waste of your time if you would make a wooden axe. Lessons in Minecraft with Sub, for dummies and for a bit more advanced minecrafters, but who still could use some tips. But you need stone, so you have got two options. You either dig down and just go hack some stone there, just a little staircase down, not too far down, because you don't have iron yet and you also don't have a furnace, so if you come across something then you need to wait, and it will be way faster to go down with an iron pickaxe anyway. But the other option is what we did, and I already see some stone way over there, and then we can just chill there and we can take the stone out of the mountain. So we just head up the mountain and then we are going to get some stone up there, and then life will be good, because then we have a little start and we are beginning to play the rest of what Minecraft has to offer. So we just need to head more up to the stones, and then we can get them and we can have a lot of stone, and then we can do whatever we want with it. Stone, we can make a house out of stone, but we could also craft tools with all of that stone, so that is just fantastic. What even more fantastic is that there is a little cave up here, so we can just enter the little cave and there is stone everywhere here, so this is just fantastic. But you know what, we are going to stay a bit of noobs, and we are just going to get rid of all the coal that is in here, and we are going to make torches instead of tools or a house, because we are not going for the stone anymore. Now we are going for that good coal, and we are going to bring a bit of light in the caves that are down here and up here if we wanted to, so that is just really great. So, we are just going to get rid of all this coal that is up here, and then we can make a crafting table or something. Wait, no, I already have one, so that is great, and then we can place it down and we can start with the crafting of all of the torches that we are going to make, so that is just great. So, we are just going to craft outside as we do. So we are heading outside, and then we find a good spot for our special crafting table, and then we can craft the torches, and everything is going to be great. I think it would look fantastic here, so let's put it down here, and it looks amazing. I could make a wallpaper out of this, that is how amazing the crafting table looks. Well then, I think this is that one cave that was hunted. I am not sure, but it looks to be the story about a boy underneath stones. A boy named Brian was on camp with his school. They were chilling, and as boys do, they went to a cave and explored the cave for a bit. But the cave was pretty deep at one point. It seems to be like this cave is that cave, but I am not sure guys, so it is kind of scary. So all the way down in this cave the boys saw something that was all the way down at the bottom. And some boy said that this was a haunted cave, so he ran out. Now there were just four more boys in the cave. Well, I am not including the thing that was living down there. But the legend has it that, underneath the bottom there was the boy underneath the stones. Brian passed out because he was really scared, and he was dreaming about all kinds of stuff, but the dream felt so real. He was in a cave that was that same cave, and he was just wandering around in that cave. But he did have a pickaxe, so he was just chilling with his pickaxe. He saw some stone that was not stone, but it was like sand, but then a bit different. It felt and sounded as sand, but it was gray. It was a weird sand. It did not look good. He was afraid of the weird looking sand, so Brian turned his head. In a matter of seconds, he was running from the cave and he wanted to go outside. He woke up outside of the cave and there was a crafting table there, so that was kind of cool. And he decided that he wanted some tools. So as you do, you walk up to that crafting table and you just craft what you need, and that was a pickaxe and a sword. So you just make that. But wait, where are we in a story? No, in matter of fact, I was Brian, and that was just a little story of when I used to be in school and that kind of happened to me. So that was just a little story to scare all of you for a bit. The Minecraft beta was actually really friendly to you, so I wanted to spice it up just a little bit because it is just so peaceful out here, which can be good, but sometimes it is not good. But with all of that said, we're just going to have a relaxing walk through the grass and next to the waters and the dunes and all of that. Oh my god, yes, this is really relaxing. Picking some flowers in the progress. This is really good for you if you are stressed out. I now have got a couple of flowers, so now I am a really cool guy. But we can be even cooler if we would be the ones that are going to make a boat. So we are going to make a boat, and then we are going to use the boat, and then we are going to have a beautiful time in these beautiful waters, and then everything is going to be amazing and we can forget about stress and all of that. The water will take my stress away, so we out here in the waters not having anywhere to go, and life is just fantastic in here. We are just chilling in the water. But we are not wet because our boat is getting wet for us and we are dry in the boat. We are just going to land the boat right here. Wait, you don't land a boat. What do you do with the boat then? I am not sure, but I know that this little beach is really nice. There is even grass and things here, so that is just nice. But now we can continue our journey, which we don't really have, but we can continue it anyway. But I see a lot of pigs and I see a lot of future food, so that could be really nice for us if we had some food in the future so we can eat and stuff, so that would just be fantastic. And then we can make a fire and we can throw some pork on the fire, and then we are going to have a fantastic meal and we can feast and all of that. It would just be nice, but we don't want to kill all the piggy because they are really cute, so just let some of them chill and then everything is going to be alright. So we are just going to go out here and then we are going to change to a world which has more future than this world, and it is just going to be amazing. And as you could see, the transformation was marvelous. Now we are out here with my trusted skin and my trusted arm that you guys can see, which is really nice. We still have all our stuff from when Minecraft was still in beta, which is also really nice, so we don't have to start all over again. But now we can chill in the good Minecraft. Well, I don't know, let me know down below what the good Minecraft is. I know that I am not doing my own tactic with the axe thing, so that is also really fantastic. But wait, hold up, this tree has to go, so I am going to get the tree out of here, and like that it is taking a little while with the wooden axe, but that is okay if you have time, I guess. So that is just fantastic. We are just chilling here now and that is great and all of that, but we need to have something where we can live and something that we can eat. And we are just going to gather a lot of wood, because as I could already see, it is starting to get night, which is not so great. Then we have to be really careful and all of that. We don't want to get eaten or anything, so let's just take it easy. And we have got a lot of wood now, so that is just great. Now we can chill with a lot of wood, which would be a chiller chill than if you chill without wood. Yes, I hope you can agree with me on that one. But you just take that wood that you are chilling with, and then you transform it into wooden planks and you have got even more wood that you can chill with, which is just fantastic. So let's go ahead and do all of that, and then we can turn in the birch wood and also the oak wood, and then we would have two stacks of wood planks, and then we are basically really rich because I don't know anyone who has that many wood, except for myself, because I have that many wood, which is just great. But now what are we going to do? The sun is now really going away, oh god no. Why does the sun not just chill with us? I will give it some wood. I don't know why wood is now a thing that you chill with, but I guess every time that you are going to chill, wood is nearby or something, I don't know, so let just not make that into a thing that you are going to chill with wood, and let just enjoy the rest of what there is to enjoy in this crazy world that is now all adapted and stuff. But the moon is now coming up, so that is not so good, but in the water, we are safe and we have got this amazing boat which keeps us safe from the water. I don't think it keeps us safe from the monsters, but I don't really see any monsters, so that is just great. And the moon is now fully up. Well, not fully, but he is coming up and he looks really angry. I don't know why he looks angry, but he just looks angry. I don't know. Hey there, is one zombie there? So that is alright, so let's just continue our journey to I don't even know where, but that is all the fun of the journey. If you don't know where you are going, I guess we are just going to stop and do something with the something that we are going to come across, and then we are just going to chill there or something. Hey, there is already a torch in here. Am I lost or have I been here before? I am not sure. I think this is the cave of the boy who lives underneath, but I know that this world is now safe, so I am not afraid anymore. I could build my house here if I want. Wait, I was Brian. I am so confused right now, so let's just build a house and then we have somewhere we can stay. As we are already familiar with this place, this is just great, and it seems like Mr. Spider also wants a quick visit to my almost new house. He looks kind of chill, but we have killed him anyways, since I don't know if he is going to creep up on me in my sleep. And we can have that, so we have to get rid of all the unsafety stuff that we can. The zombie also needs to die because of that, so that is just fantastic that now both of them are gone and now we can sleep in peace and we don't have to worry about making a door. Which would be kind of smart if we would build a door, but it would be a real cave with a door. That is kind of the problem, I guess. But we are just going to make this our main cabin and then we are just going to throw doors into this instead of the main cave that we are going to be in. This is kind of low-key amazing, this little cabin that we made. It is a really simple design, but I think it just looks fantastic. I don't know what it is, but it just looks good. And it is kind of on a corner, but not really, so that is also amazing. But we have got the doors in now, so this is just fantastic. Now we can fully live down here and we can chill with the wood down there, and that is just going to be amazing. Now we just need to finish our entire house from the inside, since the outside is already done and all of that. So the inside is a bit more ugly than the outside, because the outside is just a mountain, so nature is my outside. And I don't need myself no walls to protect my house, because I have got stone and dirt. And if you would think about a stone and dirt house, then you would expect something ugly. But we have got something really amazing, and we just have a mountain as our house. And we are kind of like a mole or something, because we are also living in the ground. But we are not really a mole, since we are not home. I don't know what that had to do with a mole, but we are not a mole. We are just living life as a mole, so that is just fantastic. We are chilling outside at the moment and it is still really dark, so I don't know when it is going to be light, but I would appreciate it if it was going to be light. But we can pop torches if we want, so we then have a little light. And that little light is already really appreciated by me, and we are just going up this mountain and there is going to be light on the mountain, so now the mountain is really amazing, and I think this mountain always wanted some light on top of itself, so that is just amazing. Well, I think that it is just really great that this mountain likes to chill with me, since I like to chill. But it would have been way cooler if we made our little house in this mountain instead of that hill thing that we actually chose. But our house is still really cool anyways, so I don't really care. But at this moment we can head back to our little shabby house that is not inside a really tall mountain but inside a little mountain, and it is just really cozy in our house, which is really important. Because you can have a really large villa, but what would you do there if you have got so many space? Well, you could do a lot, and that is the problem, because in this little house that I have built you can do much, so that is more amazing, and you need to go outside and stuff to do things because you can do things inside. But we are back at our amazing little shabby house. I am proud of my house though. We are not looking like really rich people, but it is just something that is livable, which is the main game, I guess. But it is quite amazing that it is just such a simple room and we don't really have any furniture in here, which sucks, I guess, but it is amazing that there is even a thing in here. But we are working on that, don't you even worry, child. It is all going to get fixed in a minute. And if I would just had killed all those cute little piglets when we were still in the beta, then I would have something to eat right now and I could also fix my health and my food bar. But I didn't do that because the piggy were really cute, so I guess the pigs can now live on, but we can barely live on. But we are able to manage, so I shouldn't really complain. I mean, those piggy don't even have a house, so if they would look at how I am living right now, so luxurious, then they would just want to live with me, and then we could have like a barn inside this mountain. Oh my god, that would totally be awesome. Why haven't I thought of that before? I am not sure, but that would have been a really good idea if I had a really large mountain like that one that is on the other side of my mountain. Or I could build a barn there and I could just be neighbors with the pigs. I don't know anymore, dude. So much choice, so little space, little time, because we are also at that time again, which is the least favorite time. But I hope all of you guys enjoyed this video with the alpha to beta, and it was a blast playing the beta again, and I will see all of you guys later. See you guys.